officer, but think of the disastrous effect this might have on the morale of the American teenager. No, I'm not suggesting that the boy doesn't want to go into the army, it's just that... Well, it seems to me that... No, I'm not trying to. 2 weeks from today, at the induction center, he'll be there. Rosie, thank God you're here. This is the end of the Alabama Music Corporation. Conrad Birdie is going into the army.
And your faithful secretary is hereby submitting her resignation.
Huh?
Just dropped in to say goodbye, Albert, darling. Lots of luck.
Rosie, you can't. Not today of all days. My pills. Where are my pills? You know, the little white ones I take when I'm overwrought.
Here.
Not so much. Break it in half.
You are 33 years old, Albert. You can take a whole aspirin.
I'm not 33. I'm a long ways from 33. I won't be 33 until tomorrow, Lark.
It's no use, Albert. My mind's made up. I've been with Al Maylou for 8 years now, and as you well know, I've been a lot more than just a secretary to you.
Rosie, those were moments of madness.
Well, between the moments of madness in the office, I've put in a good 90-hour week. And for what? A $5 raise in 1954 and a bottle of Arpège last Christmas?
Promise her anything, but give her Arpège. Rosie!
Yes, but not for a 16th of an ounce. And besides, I want more than that.
Rosie, if you're referring to anything of a more permanent nature between you and me, I'm not ready for it. Besides, there are religious differences.
Spanish is not a religion.
And if it's part of the company you're after, the answer is no to that, too. Al May Lou is me, Mama, and Lou. And any change in that would kill that wonderful woman who bore me.
Nothing could kill your mother, Albert, except for maybe a silver bullet.
And I won't drop poor Lou either. He loves you, Rosie.
I loved Lou too. Sure, he was warm and loyal and lovable, but he died 6 years ago. And besides, he was a wire-haired terrier. Albert, what I want is much more important than that.
Rosie, if you're going to discuss what I think you're going to discuss, I'm in no mood to discuss it.
There's nothing to discuss, Albert. Conrad Birdie is going into the army. I have quit. There's nothing left for you to do but to give up the business and go back to college.
Rosie, I am up to my ears in debt. Conrad's got a $50,000 guarantee, which I can't pay. And besides, I've just taken a severe overdose of aspirin.
Albert, this may be your last chance. Will you listen to me, Albert? I'm serious.
Thank you. was goodbye, Geoffrey Chaucer. Hello, William Morris. Goodbye, NYU. Hello, Al Maine Lucas. You wrote Conrad's last hit, Ugga Bugga Boo. Then I knew that was it. You were through with English forever. An English teacher is really someone. How proud I
about the prom?
I'm so tied up.
Saturday?
Yeah.
World War II.
Thank you.
Albert, without any help from you.
Oh, I'm sorry, Rosa. I don't suppose a generous tip would help clear things up.
Just take your briefcase and get down to that train before any of those reporters talk to Conrad alone. You know what happened the last time.
Rosie, you're going to have to hang on to it. I have to wait here for Mom.
Speaking of your mother, Albert, have you told her about dissolving Al Melu yet?
I couldn't, Rose. Yesterday was the anniversary.
Of what?
Lou. 6 years ago, he was hit on 181st Street in Broadway by a loaded beer truck. Do you suppose that's Mom?
Well, it's either that or the all clear.
Mama! Oh, Mama, what's the matter?
Oh, don't worry about me, Sonny. I'm just a little faint from the subway.
Subway? Mama, I told you to take a taxi.
Taxi? What do I need with taxis? I'll need the taxi for my successful son. A mother can ride crowded in a dirty subway full of foreign people who wouldn't give you a seat if your life depended on it. But what's the difference? Nowadays, the mother's lower than dirt, anyway. Here's the money I saved from not taking the taxi. Buy some candy with it. Who's she?
Oh, Mama, you remember Rose Alvarez from the office?
This is Rose Alvarez? Pretty little Rose Alvarez? I can't believe it. Rose, what happened? You had a sudden shock or something?
Excuse me, Albert. I think I'll just see if Conrad's here yet.
Oh, by all means, Miss Alvarez. Oh, look at her, Sonny. How nice she looks. It's a wonder to me some older man hasn't snatched her off. A personal matron like that for brains and a few dollars. What a catch you'd be for a convalescent.
How do you feel about going to the army?
How does he feel? Do you ask how he feels? He's not too shy to tell you so often. Proud to be a plain GI.
He will gladly face those bullets, for he's not afraid to die.
For he's a Yeah. She goes around kissing someone else.
That's what's so important. I'll have you know I'm very upset about this. We had a few headaches and a nosebleed today.
Oh.
to our city. Comrade Birdie!
Ah! He said it! He said the name! Ah!
What happened? All I said was Comrade Birdie.
Ah!
If you girls don't stop that, I can't finish my speech!
Who cares about your speech? We want to hear from Conrad!
Yeah!
Thank you.
caught, Kim, happens to be my breakfast, and I intend enjoying it.
Your father has a right to enjoy his eggs, Kim.
Yes.
But I'm sure he wouldn't mind if we just started to slowly clear away some of these other things. I know it's been a bit hectic this morning, dear, but Kim's gone to a lot of trouble to fix a special breakfast for Mr. Birdie, and I want to make sure everything's ready and waiting for him when he comes down. After all, he is a national figure, and I want to show these New York people that we know how to treat a national figure here in Sweet Apple. Oh, of course, it doesn't mean that much to me personally, but for Kim's sake. There we are, all done. Did you enjoy it, dear? Good. Now, if you'll just move along.
Doris, I'm not budging from this room until I've had my coffee, smoked a cigarette, and read the newspaper.
I'm sorry, dear. I didn't have time to make your coffee this morning. How about a nice warm 7-Up?
Morning, Clark. Here's your paper. I hope you don't mind. I cut out a few stories about Conrad.
I have tried to run this house on a democratic basis. I have extended the privilege of self-determination both to the woman I married and to the children I have sired. No one has been denied the vote for reasons of age, sex, or political affiliation. There has been no taxation without representation, and all open covenants have been openly arrived at. Last night, I gave up my room to a guest who repeatedly referred to me as Pat. Telephone calls made on my phone to New York, Chicago, Fairbanks, Alaska, and Hong Kong. I slept on a camp cot with my feet in the fireplace, my head in an ashtray. Outside my window, three harpies shrieked,
"We love you, Tommy!"
4,723 times. I've just lost two Fridays. Well, gentlemen, the democracy is over. Parliament is dissolved. The Magna Carta is revoked. And Nero is back in town. And you don't offer an emperor a war 7-Up!
Oh, Mr. McAfee, I hope you won't mind keeping up the phone for a few minutes. We're expecting a long-distance call from New York.
Perfectly all right. I'll just go out and burn Rome.
Oh, nothing, dear. Your father's just excited about Conrad being here. That's all.
I'll get the eggs. Mother, you call the kids.
Girls, he's coming. You'd better hurry if you want to watch him eat.
Kim, granddaughter, is this any way that you...
you want 75 million Americans to see you?
What are you talking about?
You're all going to be on television with Conrad.
On television?
That's right. I just got the confirmation from New York, from Ed Sullivan himself.
You mean, we're going to be on the Sullivan Show? The Ed Sullivan Show.
Yes, sir. They're going to cut in here at Sweet Apple this Sunday at 8:05. You're all going to be on. That's why I beg you, Mr. McAfee, to put aside your petty differences.
To that great audience out there, your American dream come true. And for the free world's sake, Mr. McAfee, don't destroy that dream.
Me, on the Ed Sullivan Show.
Ed Sullivan.
Me, Harry McAfee, appearing with
Ed Sullivan.
Yes. Hey, Dave, step three.
Oh, Gloria! Say hello to Gloria Brashington.
Hi now!
Say, you're kind of cute.
Mama, I don't need a secretary. I have Rosie.
Oh, what does Rosie need a job for? In a couple of years, she'll be getting Social Security.
Well, listen, I don't just type, you know.
You do other things?
Sure, I can dance. I think I can help you with this secretarial stuff. I need to get me into show business. Here, hold this thing.
Oh, well, I just happen to have the words right here.
Get a load of this.
Gathered to bid farewell to a typical American soldier.
Comrade Birdie!
Where's Ed?
Oh!